Hello everyone, I'm going to start on a new project and this will be an experiment because I want to use thin geode coasters that I will also be making in this video and I want to incorporate them in a geode serving tray. So very exciting and it's all about experimenting and I love to experiment as you all know. I am going to show you almost the whole process of how to make this serving tray with the coasters. And so for the new people to my channel that like experiments, in this case of a resin, but I also have tutorials of acrylics, mixed media and a lot more, consider to subscribe, click the notification bell and select all because that way you don't miss any future videos that I will be uploading to my channel. So I already started with adding a first food safe clear layer in the serving tray geode mold and this will be a thin layer because on top of this layer I will be adding the geode coasters, but first I need to make those coasters. I'm not going to make them that thick, they need to be really thin because I'm going to work in layers. But yeah, first a clear layer of food safe resin. And this is the food safe resin of Resin Pro. The link is in the description box. So now I'm going to make 7 geode coasters. And I'm using the R-Pro resin for making these coasters. Starting with a little bit of clear, there you can see it. The mold on the right side is from Molds and Shape. All the information, if you are interested, is in the description box. The only thing you need to do is send them a message through their Facebook page. And then it will all be okay. They ship worldwide, so that's great. And it are amazing molds. So if you're interested, the information is in the description box. The molds on the left side, the 3 molds, I made them myself of real geode slices. I will add a link to that in the right corner so that you can see how I make the silicon molds, but also how I pour in those silicon molds. So the first color is one of Lares. It's the sapphire blue. It's the paste. Very nice deep blue color. And I'm going to use the petal technique to create some nice effects. There you can see it on top of the clear. So that it flows much better to the sides if you pour on clear resin. Also on the other 3 silicon molds. And now I'm using a Bombay ink. No, that's not true. I'm using a Pinata alcohol ink. It's the Baya Blue. In the middle of the Sapphire Blue. And I let it flow to the sides. There you can see it. And I keep pouring in the middle of the color underneath. Now again a color of Lares, it's again the blue sapphire, but then the powder. In the middle. So these coasters will be different shades of blue. I think that will look nice. And I'm going to make 2 sets of 7. I'm only going to show you 1 set. And I want to incorporate them in the serving tray. This is the Karsten Craft White, also in the middle. Again, the Pinata Baya Blue. And I hope they will be transparent, because I think that will look nice if I add them in the serving tray, because the serving tray I will be using a lot of clear. Sorry for my friend's bulldog, he's very loud. And again, I'm using the Lares Sapphire Blue powder, only a small puddle, on top the Karsenkraut White, and hopefully I can create some nice effects. I'm using a Bombay ink turquoise, and I mixed in some sparkle white and also 2 drops of alcohol, 99%. So I'm not going to fill the silicone molds all the way to the top. I want them really thin, because if I fill the mold on the right side all the way to the top, then the coasters are 1.5 centimeters thick. Yeah, I think that's too thick for what I have in mind. The embossing tool for the air bubbles. And then I'm done with the coasters. Need to let them dry before I can take them out of the mold. So we are 24 hours later, now I can remove the coasters out of the mold. Need to be very carefully, because they are still a little bit bendy. But I have some nice effects, I like them a lot. So I'm very excited how, if I can mix a nice serving tray with these coasters incorporate in them, in it. Now the other 3 silicone molds, also very nice. Also have some transparent parts, so that's great. So now we can take a closer look. What I need to do with these coasters is sand the sharp edge that I have, because otherwise I can't add them into the serving tray. So the sharp edge needs to be removed, but they look great. So I never done this before, this is an experiment, what I have in mind. So if it's not totally perfect, then yeah, we can learn from it. Really nice. So I'm going to start on the second layer of the serving tray. So I'm using the ArtPro resin, so not the food safe, but the normal ArtPro resin. I'm pouring a little bit where I want to have the first coaster. So on top of the clear, I'm pushing the coaster down. There you can see it, pressing it, adding more clear where I want to have my second coaster. So what I already mentioned, I sand the sharp edge with a paper nail file, then I clean it with some alcohol, and then I can add it on top of the serving tray, or on the top of the first layer. So again, a little bit of clear. Remove some air bubbles with my heat gun. And on top of the clear, I'm adding the coaster. There you can see it. Pressing it down. So, and this will get several layers. And on each layer, I will be adding coasters. So, this is also a nice technique if you want... If you have made coasters that you are not satisfied of, or there are some imperfections, then you can use them for this kind of art. Yes, I'm also going to add some glitter lines. I'm using the Fusion Glass Glitter in a nice gold. Sparkles a lot, so I will be making some lines on different layers so that I can create the depth that I want. So, and if the mold, this geode tray mold is filled all the way to the top, then it will be 1.5 centimeters thick, so a nice thickness. Yeah, because this glass glitter is heavier than the other glitters, it will not spread to the side that much. So I'm adding the glitter in a paper cup and I add a little bit of resin, and then I make the lines where I want it. And another line. Yeah, hopefully this will work out. I have no idea. Yeah, and all the supplies I've used in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box with the links to the website. So if you're curious, please check out the description box. There's a lot of information. I get a lot of questions where I buy my material, so please take a look. There's a lot of information in the description box. Adding more clear to fill the gaps. Spreading it with my stirring stick. And also this geode serving tray mold is from Molds and Shapes. And what I already mentioned, if you're interested, the link to their Facebook page is in the description box. And they have a lot of amazing molds. And they ship worldwide, what I already said, and the link is in the description box. Again, we are 24 hours later and the second layer is dry, so I'm starting on the third layer. Again, I'm pouring some clear where I want to have the next coaster. Again, I'm using the Art Pro resin from Resin Pro. And again, I sanded the sharp edge, cleaned it with alcohol, and now I'm adding it on top of the second layer. Again, a little bit of clear. heat gun to remove some air bubbles. And on top of the clear, the next coaster. Yeah, and I also want to mention my promo codes. I have a promo code of the Resin Pro company. And if you use my code Petra, then you get 10% discount on your total value order. So that's great. But I have three other promo codes. They are all in the description box. So if you're curious, please check out the description box. All the information to the promo codes you can find there. So that was the third coaster. Now I will be adding more clear around it. Yeah, and I have no idea how this is going to look, but we will see. Also on this layer, I will be adding a glitter line. What I already mentioned, I want to create that depth. So also on top of some coasters. More clear on top of the coasters that I just added. Spreading it with my steering stick. More of the glass glitter. And then I'm almost done with the third layer. And again, I need to let this dry before I can add the fourth layer. Again, we are 24 hours later, and this will be the fourth layer. And again, I'm going to add some coasters. Adding clear. And again, using the ArtPro resin. Removing air bubbles and on top the coaster, pressing it down. There you can see it. And I already can see that it's not totally perfect because I have some air bubbles. But that's no problem. It's all about experimenting and showing it to you all. And we can learn from each other. So if someone has a great idea to not have any air bubbles, but I think it's because I'm pressing it, what you see now, pressing it down onto the clear. But I need to have clear underneath those coasters. But still, I think it looks already very nice. Adding more glitter. So now I have glitter lines on different layers, but also coasters on different layers. Hopefully I have some great depth. And at the end of this video, of course, I will show you all a close-up. Yeah, and this serving tray will be very thick. It will be thicker than 1.5 centimeters because I also want to add a food safe layer on the top side. So the side you see now. Adding more clear to fill in all the gaps. Yeah, this is an experiment totally different than I, or an art piece totally different than I normally make. But I think this is a great way to combine coasters and a serving tray together. More clear. And then I'm almost done with the fourth layer. I will let this dry before I can take it out of the mold. So the resin is dry. Now I can take it out of the mold, and normally I don't have any issues with that. Doesn't stick to the silicon mold because I don't use a torch. There you can see it, it's not flat yet because I want to add a food safe layer on top of this, but it looks great. Also, that's the backside of the serving tray. Yeah, it has a lot of depth. I think it looks great. I'm very pleased how it looks so far. So I'm going to add a food safe layer. What I didn't show you is that I've added some gilding liquid lines on around some coasters. You can see it in a nice gold color. And now I'm adding a food safe layer on top, spreading it with my steering stick. There you can see it. I think those lines look nice. So this serving tray can be used on both sides. And yeah, if the client wants to have handles on it, then it's also possible, but I don't like handles. That's why I'm not adding those. But I think it looks great. A great way to also use coasters, not only to use them to put your cup of tea on it, but you can also incorporate them in a serving tray. Very nice. Let me know what you think of this experiment. Hopefully I have inspired you all to try it. And of course I have taped the backside so that I can remove the drips easy. So I need to let this dry and then I will show you all the end result. So this is the end result, and yeah, it looks great. It's not perfect because there are some air bubbles in it, but it's an experiment and I learned a lot from this experiment. Now I'm trying to show you the depth, because as you can have seen, I added the geode coasters on different layers and also the glitter lines on different layers. There you can see some air bubbles on top of the coaster. So it's not perfect, but I had so much fun creating this serving tray with the coasters added into it. And it looks great. And this is the other side. Also here, this side is not perfect. I had some leakage on the sides. And maybe I will sand it down and then polish it. But I think it looks amazing. Also, the gilding lines are great. And it has a lot of depth. So let me know what you think of this experiment. Hopefully I have inspired you all to also try it out. Maybe you have some ideas to prevent those air bubbles or whatever. I'm open to any suggestions. So if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. That would help my channel a lot. All the information to the materials I've used in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box with the website links, also the link to my Instagram and Facebook page. I want to thank you all for watching again, and hopefully I will see you in the next video. Bye.